I am Dr. Chandni Pradeep, working as a pediatrician and lactational consultant at Ahalya Hospital, Hamdan. Yet another new year, 2021. Happy New Year to one and all from the Department of Pediatrics, Ahalya Group. Nowadays, children are attending school in three different ways. One is the face-to-face schooling where he or she goes to school. Second is the online or the virtual schooling. And the third is a hybrid. That is, some days they go to school and sometimes they attend school online. Now, coming to the children who are attending school regularly, that is on all days, what precautions should the parents take? One, they should teach the children how to wear and remove the mask, because mask is a new ornament that we have all got. So they should always hold the mask by the thread and take it out with the thread and wear it with the thread. And they should not touch the mask. They should wash the hands before and after both removing as well as wearing the mask. Secondly, they should not share their mask with anyone. Once they are removing the mask to eat food or some other purpose, they should keep it in a sealed cover and take it out and wear it when necessary. Then once the mask is used and they want to dispose, they should not throw it away on the floor but dispose it properly in a dustbin. Second thing is, they should know how to wash their hands with soap and water. The various movements of hand washing should be taught to children as well, and you can very well learn it from the YouTube. And if soap and water are not available, they should be made to wash the hands with hand sanitizer, which should be provided to each child, and they should wash the hands with a sanitizer with more than 60% alcohol. Then they should also know how to clean the surfaces that they are regularly using. Then these small children, in many of the schools, they are made to be taught in cohorts. That is, the same group shares all studies and play. So they should be let known that they should adhere to their cohort or the group and should not be moving to the other groups. The other older children who are attending regular classes without being in a cohort, they should keep basic minimum distance, that is 6 feet or 2 meter, that is physical distancing. Then the next thing is, the children should be taught the cough etiquette. That is, if they are coughing or sneezing, they should not be closing their mouth with their palms. Instead, they should do it with the fold of the elbow so that it will not touch any other place. Then they should be taught how to enter and alight the buses. If they are using public transport, that is school buses, they should know how to maintain social or the physical distancing even while entering and alighting from the bus and which seats to occupy. Once they reach home, they should keep their shoes outside in a designated place and it should be sanitized later. So also, their school bags should not be thrown onto the beds or cots or tables, but it should be on a designated place at the entrance and should be sanitized before taking them inside. After reaching home from school, all of them should take a good bath with soap and water, then change their clothes, and the clothes should find their proper place in the laundry bag. Then the parents should be very careful that they should not be sending their children to school if they have any symptoms of fever, cough or cold. Lastly, the parents should also be aware, like every year they are taking the flu vaccine, same way the flu vaccine should be taken for all children during this season, because the flu as well as the COVID-19 have got basic symptoms same, that is, they have got cough, cold and fever, and it will be very difficult to differentiate between them symptomatically. So it's better that we take the flu vaccine and protect our children. Coming to those who are attending online classes, they should be under supervision of the parents. It's not that the parents should impose themselves upon their children, but they should have a steady eye on them, on what contents the children watch and how they are attending to the classes. And most of their plays nowadays are again with social or the visual media. So they should make the children play a different mode so that they are not again exposed to their mobiles and computers. Secondly, who are attending these virtual classes, they should have eye checkups regularly because they are concentrating on the computers for a long time, there is a chance that they might develop refractive error. Secondly, as far as possible, if there is only one child or if there are more than one TV available at home, it's better that the schooling be done on that the device be connected to the TV. And secondly, it's better that they use headphones instead of earphones. If possible, it is always better that the sound comes from the TV, but if not, it's better, the second option would be headphones. And if the child complains of any earache, they should have an ENT opinion also, because they are getting exposed to this earphone sounds for 8 hours a day. And lastly, for those who are going for hybrid classes, that is when they are going some days to school and sometimes they are attending online classes, still they are exposed to both the risks and they should take care of both these things regularly. Thank you.